Dear student, welcome back to the chapter, that is it. Today we will cover the remaining part, and this is the third and the last video on this chapter. I not only covered this topic, subtopic, but also I will show you the NCERT book, that is the chapter heat, and obviously complete the chapter and exercise. Okay, so now watch the video till the end. First of all, we will discuss about the kind of clothes we wear in summer and winter. Especially for the color, what type of color we choose, light color or dark color. So if you want to know what color is preferable for with respect to the summer or winter season, then we have to execute one activity. So activity. Now we have taken two container, metal container, the same metal container we have taken, named as 1 and 2. And we have painted black the whole surface, the outer surface we have painted black color. And this one is generally a stainless steel container. Okay, and we have poured the same amount of water in both the container. And keep these two container under hot sunshine, under sun, for half an hour. And what will be the observation after half an hour? If you put your hands in both the two container, you will feel the first container will be hotter with respect to the second container. Why? The explanation is that the sun rays are coming, the heat energy is coming from sun and falls equally in both the two container. But as it is a stainless steel container, the surface of the container is shiny, so its maximum heat energy is reflected back by this surface. So what is happening in the stainless steel container, that is a light colored container, so maximum heat which is coming from the sun is not absorbed, it is reflected back. So very less amount of heat energy is absorbed by this stainless steel container. And what is happening for the painted black container? As it is black, you know, black color absorbs the maximum amount of heat which is coming from the sun. That's why it will be heated up, because very less amount of energy for this case is reflected back. Maximum amount of energy is absorbed in the first container. That's why it will be hotter. So what is the conclusion we have learned? Conclusion is that light color cloth absorb less amount of heat and reflected back maximum amount of energy. What is happening for the dark color? Dark color cloth absorb maximum amount of heat energy and less amount of heat energy is absorbed. So in summer is generally hot season. So in this hot season, what type of cloth should you wear? Obviously we choose light color, because light color like white color, baby pink color, like this color, what good for summer season, because in the summer season this type of light color cloth will absorb less amount of energy, maximum amount of energy will be reflected back, you will feel cool with respect to the other type of color in the summer. Comfort level will be greater for the case of a white color. And of course we have discussed this first question with respect to the color, but if we come to the texture and the pattern of cloth, what type of pattern of cloth should you wear? Obviously I recommend, but all knows, it will be cotton cloth. So if we complete the sentence, in the summer season we should wear light color cotton cloth. Okay, and the winter season obviously we wear dark color, and obviously instead of cotton at the time we'll wear woolen cloth. Okay, we'll talk about more about the cotton cloth. You know, cotton cloth is made up with so many such type of small yarn thread, cotton thread, like that. These are the cotton thread. Actually, cotton cloths are made up of so many cotton thread placed very densely. In the summer season, generally heavy amount of sweat will be there, and this sweat, the cotton cloth, the thread, the yarn absorb the sweat from your body and spreads over the area. If the area increases, you know, and this sweat, which is actually the water, changes its state from water to vapor, just evaporate. Evaporation process will be started. In the process of evaporation, the liquid state comes to the vapor state, and at that state, at this transition, some amount of heat energy is required, and they will get the heat energy. The heat energy is absorbed from our body. So maximum heat energy which is generated in our body will be gone. In this process, our body will be cooled down and will feel comfort. So that's why cotton cloth is necessary. Woolen cloth keeps us warm in winter. Woolen cloth is wool. Wool is such type of material in which it traps some air, and we know air is a bad conductor. If we wear woolen cloth, then due to this bad conductor, which is air, it does not allow the heat to come out. So that's why we feel warm in the winter season. At the same time, the coldness from the environment will not enter from outside to the body, because here also the bad air, that is the bad conductor, acts as the barrier. So in this process, we keep our body warm in the winter season. Sometimes this question will come, if we wear, instead of a single woolen cloth, if we wear two normal cloths, then it will be good or bad or better. I suggest it will be better. But if you again put a second cloth like that, so inside, in between the two cloths, this area, actually this area, is what is? It filled with the air, and I have told you air is a bad conductor. So in this process, you can prevent the heat energy to escape from your body, and you can also prevent the entrance of the coldness of the environment to your body. Now we'll move our attention to the NCERT book, and we'll solve the chapter and exercise, and we will emphasize on some question, why mercury is used as thermometric liquid in thermometer. Number second, why king yeast is used in clinical thermometer. Number three, why king is not used in lab thermometer. So along with the chapter and exercise, we'll also solve this question one by one. So keep watching the NCERT book. Now directly we'll go to the chapter 4 heat in its NCERT book. You can see the digital versions of the NCERT book. You can see the chapter heat and the activity. You can see this activity 4.1. Already I have stated in my first video, and the conclusions of the activity, you can see I have highlighted here this portion. We cannot always rely on our sense of touch to decide whether an object is hot or cold. Sometimes it may deceive us. Very important point. Go to the next part, measuring temperature. Reading a thermometer. How to read a thermometer? I have already shown this thing, this matter, in the video very clearly. And here I have also highlighted one point, that is, then one small division can read 1/5 is equal to 0.2 degree centigrade. if you have any issue, if you have any problem, then see my video and I have clarified these things in my video. Now next go to the normal temperature of human body is 37 degree centigrade. Students, it is in degree centigrade. Anyone, it can be expressed in Fahrenheit also. If it is expressed in Fahrenheit, it will be 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. It is a lab thermometer. You can see lab thermometer is running from minus 10 degree centigrade to 110 degree centigrade. And I have highlighted one thing here also. You can see the different types of thermometer are used for different purposes. The maximum and minimum temperature of the previous day reported in weather reports are measured by a thermometer called maximum minimum thermometer, a small knot. Why mercury is used as thermometric liquid in thermometer? So here are the points. Read the points one by one, take a note. There are total 7 points. There is a question. You can see, why does the mercury not fall or rise in a clinical thermometer when taken out of the mouth? Obviously the reason is that it used as a kink is the clinical thermometer used a kink. Kink is used in the clinical thermometer. So why kink is used in a clinical thermometer? Here is the answer. Quick look this answer and take a note. And if the same question can be asked in a different way, why kink is not used in laboratory thermometer? Dear students, it is only to take the real-time data. If we attach kink in the laboratory thermometer, I have told you different thermometer are used in different purposes. The purpose cannot be served. It is used due to the real-time data. Each and every time the increase and decrease of the temperature, it can be noted very accurately. So if we use a kink, then fall down of the mercury will be prevented. Then we cannot take the reading of the decreasing temperature. So purpose of taking reading will not be served. So that's why kink is not used. Now the next point, this is a digital thermometer. You can see now the modes of heat transfer. There are three modes of heat transfer. The definitions are, I have highlighted here. You can see the process by which the heat is transferred from the hotter end to the colder end of an object is known as the conduction. So go to the convection. Yes, this one. So here water is written, water has been written. So instead of water, the convection is process is valid for fluid. So instead of water, if students just write here fluid, then this will be the definition of convection. When fluid is heated, the fluid near the flame gets hot. Hot flame rises, sorry, flame gets hot. Hot fluid rises up and cold fluid from the sides moves down towards the source of heat. This fluid also gets hot and rises. And fluid from the sides moves down. This process continues till the whole fluid, don't use water here, whole fluid gets heated. This mode of heat transfer is known as convection. So this is the definition of convection. Now students, go to the very important applications. Examples of the convection is that seabridge and land bridge. Now go to the diagram, seabridge diagram and land bridge diagram. So don't try to draw this figure which is used in the NCERT book. It is very complex. So instead of that, write the diagram, that is schematic diagram. I have drawn the schematic diagram in my video. Check it in my video and follow it. It will consume less time in your exam. Schematic diagram means only the outlines. This is the definition of the third mode of heat transfer, that is the radiation. The radiation is a process in which it does not require any medium and heat is transformed in the form of electromagnetic wave. So it is written here, it can take place whether the medium is present or not present. Actually it does not require any medium. Now today I have clarified these points, kinds of clothes we wear in the summer and winter. This point 4.5 point. Now go to the end of this point and I have here highlighted these points. Dark surface absorb more heat and therefore we feel comfortable with dark colored cloths in the winter. Light colored cloths reflect most of the heat that falls on them and therefore we feel more comfortable wearing them in the summer.
and this one. Moreover, there is air trapped in the, why woolen cloth is used? Moreover, there is the air trapped in between the wool fibers. The air prevents the flow of heat from our body to the cold surroundings, so we feel warm. Suppose you are given a choice in the winter of using either of the thick blanket or two thin blankets joined together. What would you choose and why? I have already stated. So now directly go to the chapter and exercise. You can see this is a chapter and exercise I have already done. State the similarities and differences between the laboratory thermometer and a clinical thermometer. So this is a slide. What's this slide? These are the differences, three differences, three similarities and three differences. I have drawn three differences, three similarities and three differences are here. Give two examples each of the conductor and insulator of it. So it will be what? It will be plastic or dry wood. Fill in the blanks. The hotness of an object is determined by temperature. Temperature of boiling water cannot be measured by clinical thermometer because temperature will be increasing or decreasing. So kink is there in the clinical thermometer, so it prevents the mercury to fall down. So that's why clinical thermometer cannot be used. What type of thermometer is used here? It will be lab thermometer. Temperature is measured in degree Celsius or centigrade. Now the next point is that no medium is required for transfer of heat from the process of radiation. The third mode of vibration, third mode of heat transfer is the radiation, I have told you. A cold steel spoon is dipped in the cup of hot milk. Heat is transferred to its other end by the process of conduction. Because it is a solid body, I have told you conduction process is only valid in the solid body. And clothes of dash colors, it will be dark color, absorb more heat better than the clothes of the light color, I have stated. So now the matching, land bridge blows during, so these are the matching 1, 2, 3, 4 and here ABCD. So we have to write, we have to show the matching in this way, 1, 2, 3, 4 I have written and the words, what is written, I have to write one by one, but there is a small space is there. So to manage the space, I have written only the Roman script and here I will write the ABCD only instead of the word. So you have to write both the symbols, the Roman script 1, 2, 3, 4 and the here the right side ABCD. So I'm just writing land bridge blows during which. Land bridge means the bridge is coming from land. So bridge is land bridge is blows only when the sea surface will be heated up. Sea surface is heated up only in night. So it will be night. Answer will be D. Sea bridge blows during. So it will be day. Answer will be C. Now dark colored clothes are preferred during. So dark colored clothes absorb heat. So which time heat is comfortable? Hotness is comfortable in winter. So answer will be winter. So 3 it will be B. 3 it will be B. Now the remaining part, light colored clothes are preferred during. Preferred during. It will be summer. So answer will be A. So answer will be A. Now the remaining question is that discuss why wearing more layers of clothing during winter keeps us warmer than the wearing just one thick piece of clothing. I have told you it just the bad conductor in between the two layers of the clothes, so it will be greater amount of bad conductor, that is the air, can be trapped between the two layers of the clothing. Now there is a question 6. Now indicate the conduction, convection and radiation. Conduction. In place of hot climate, it is advised to the outer walls of the houses are painted white, because I have told you white color, light color actually reflect back all the heat energies. So it will just absorb very less amount of heat energy and that's why it will not be heated up. And now the thing is that 1 liter of water 30 degree centigrade is mixed with the 1 liter of the water 50 degree centigrade. The temperature of the mixture will be 80 degree. More than 50 degree, less than 80 degree, 20 degree centigrade, between 30 and 50. So it will be in between 30 and 50 degrees. So answer will be this one. This one will be the answer. And next question, an iron ball 40 degrees dropped in a mug containing the at 40 degree centigrade, the heat will. So it is also 40 degree, it is also 40 degree. So there is no temperature difference. If there is no temperature difference, then heat will not flow. What is this option? C, this option. Not flow from iron ball to water or from water to iron ball. So without reading other options, just take it. It will be the answer. So not flow from iron ball to water or from water to iron ball. Okay. Next, a wooden spoon is dipped in a cup of ice cream. Its other end, actually wooden spoon is a bad conductor. It is insulator of heat. So does not, so becomes cold, so options will be does not become cold. It will be the option. So it will be the option does not become cold. Next, stainless steel pans are usually provided with a copper bottom. The reasons for this could be that copper bottom makes the pan more durable. Such pans appear colorful. Copper is better conductor of heat than stainless steel. Copper is easier to clean than the stainless steel. So more appropriate answer will be C. So that's why I have to take the C option, because copper is better conductor of heat than the stainless steel. So this is the end of this chapter and exercise. So thank you for watching my video. Don't forget to subscribe my channel for the next interesting videos. Thank you.